Hello everyone, this is Bill Geissele from Geissele Automatics, and today I'm going to talk about galvanic corrosion, I hope I pronounced that right, between the barrel nut and the upper receiver. Brownells had posed this question to me and asked for my opinion on it. I am not a corrosion engineer, so I will not discuss the fundamental or theoretical aspects of this type of corrosion, all right, but I will tell you that from experience working on motorcycles and all kinds of industrial machinery, you rarely see something like an aluminum nut and aluminum bolt. Actually, I've never actually seen it before. I know I have done things that are all land-based. I don't work on aircraft, never have. So that may be something that you see in aircraft, but I can tell you that you don't want to put an aluminum nut and aluminum bolt together unless they're both coated with something. So this type of corrosion, galvanic corrosion, it does occur. I'll give you an example. The joints on the Statue of Liberty between the iron framework and the copper skin, the Statue of Liberty, the outside that you see is basically a thin copper skin that was made, and then the structure within it, it was actually designed by Eiffel, the same Frenchman who designed the Eiffel Tower. And that is the structural member inside the statue. So where the iron comes up against the copper skin over time, that had started to corrode there and corrode that connection. And in the 1980s, during some restoration work, they discovered this. And actually Eiffel, they knew about this back in the 1880s when the statue, I believe that's the era when it was built, he knew about this. But they had put some kind of a coating in between, a paint coating in between the iron structure and the copper, and this prevented that kind of corrosion. So what the United States did when we went to refurbish the statue is they put a thin Teflon sheet in there in order to separate the copper and the iron. The Royal Navy also saw the same type of galvanic corrosion when they first started to copper clad the hulls of ships in order to prevent all the marine organisms from attacking the wooden hull. The copper was nailed on with iron nails, and after a voyage, they'd come back and some of the nails were just absolutely corroded away and other ones were fine. They didn't understand it, but what they noticed was the nails that were good, there was a small piece of brown paper, okay, evidently, underneath the nail head, and this prevented the iron nail from contacting the copper. Most likely, it was some type of a paper covering of the copper that they had put on there to protect it and keep it shiny, and they would work with it and put it up on the ship, and then they nailed through the paper and then tore the paper away. That's my guess, all right? But there was some type of an electrically inhibiting coating between the two metals. Now, when it comes to the upper receiver and the barrel nut fit, it's traditionally always been a steel barrel nut, of course, on an aluminum upper receiver. So this type of corrosion has not been an issue traditionally with those two metals. Now, I've been making rails now for approximately a decade, and the first barrel nuts that we made, of course, were steel because that was the traditional material. But as you looked at steel, and our barrel nut is a lot bigger than the stock M16A2 type barrel nut, we wanted to save some weight. So the question was, can we use the aluminum one? So I experimented with aluminum ones. All the testing came out just fine. So very shortly after I started making rails, I'm saying this is about 2011 or so, so about 9 years now, we switched over completely to aluminum, except for the Mark 7 rail, which is our national match rail that the high power shooters want. They want a heavy rail. That's why we include lead weights with it, so you can balance your you can balance your weight. So that Mark 7 barrel nut is very heavy profile. It's not machined out at all, and it's due to the desire for weight in a national match competition gun. So you're talking about 9 years at least of aluminum barrel nuts, and let me tell you about the problems that we've had with the threads and the aluminum barrel nut. I know of one issue with it, and I believe that barrel nut, I don't know how the gentleman cross-threaded it, but it was actually cross-threaded on the upper. We wound up cutting it off, and his threads were all jabongered on the upper, if I'm not mistaken. This was years ago. So there's only ever been one issue. If you know about the URGI program, the upper receiver group improved. Okay, we have the rail on that program, our Mark 16 rail, that has an aluminum barrel nut, 7075 T6 barrel nut. Again, no issues whatsoever. And all the testing that Crane has done with this, there were never any issues with it. Now, let me explain about the coatings on this, because that's important. If I was going to design some type of a bolted joint with, and I desired lightweight, and I was going to use an aluminum bolt and aluminum nut, I know from how aluminum interacts with each other under load, it would immediately gall. The same thing with stainless steel. Many stainless steels gall. And what that means is it picks up metal and it'll lock the joint up. For instance, your usual 18-8 fasteners that you get for boats. You go to the marine store, you get some quarter 20 nuts and bolts, and you're gonna fasten something together. It's all great and wonderful, right? Well, you spin those suckers on and you tighten it up, and I've had those things just lock up on me and I couldn't move them and get them off because the stainless steel galls. So what you have to do is you have to put something in that bolted joint, like an anti-seize, which is a paste with some type of metallic compound, in order to insulate that, in order to provide some lubrication. All right. So the aluminum that you see in an upper receiver and on our barrel nut, they're both hard coat anodized. Now, what is that? Anodizing, there's different types, type 1, 2, 3. All right. 3 is called hard coat. It actually builds up a layer on the outside of the aluminum and on the inside of the aluminum of aluminum oxide. Okay, think of a grinding wheel that you would see on a bench grinder that you would sharpen your lawnmower blades on. That's the exact material that's in that grinding wheel. It's like a ruby. Okay, it's the same material. This is a hard stone-like material, and it penetrates half into the aluminum and half out of it. All right, so when you're actually tightening this up, all right, you're not tightening up on aluminum to aluminum. Even if that anodized wears away, like in your upper receiver where the bolt carrier runs, still you have a thousandth of an inch of anodized that's penetrated into the aluminum. So now you have a barrel nut that's gonna go on to the upper receiver, and they're both anodized, so you don't have aluminum to aluminum contact. This is your non-conductive barrier right here. Just as in the Royal Navy ships where you had the brown paper, just like on the Statue of Liberty where there's now a thin film of Teflon in between it. Okay, so you don't have aluminum to aluminum, so this type of galvanic corrosion really won't apply. Now, on any good bolted joint, you must lubricate it. Okay, now a lot of people might not believe in it. If you're an old school Harley guy, you're never gonna lubricate your bolts because they're gonna vibrate loose. All right, that's a bad joint in bolted joint terminology. If you can't put some type of lubricant, okay, on your bolt and on your nut, that's really not a well-designed joint that is not able to handle that, because you want to minimize those torsional effects of the nut as it starts to jam itself and those 60-degree threads start to interact with each other. If you don't have a lubrication on it, you will not get the proper and consistent pull on the bolt, and that pull is what makes your joint tight. Okay, you're stretching your bolt. It's not tight, you're not tightening anything, quote unquote. You are pulling that bolt, and that stretch, that elongation, is what gives you your clamping force, all right, your preload on the joint. So that's what you're after when you tighten something up. So a good joint is going to be able to handle lubricant. And of course, on all our barrel nuts, before we send them out the door, they all get painted with an anti-seize. We use a nickel type anti-seize. This is a special type of lubricant with powdered nickel inside of it. It's nuclear grade. They use it a lot of nuclear power plants, because they don't like copper in their systems. I'm not sure why, but it's always been nuclear grade, this nickel based, and we paint the inside of the threads. So when you spin your nut on, you're not gonna have to remember to put oil on it, even though that's good practice, okay? Because it gives you consistent joint. You go dry to dry, you're not gonna get consistent torque. This one might torque up real well, and the next one might lock up. So you always want some lube on it. Okay, and if you're taking your Geissele barrel nut on that you've had for years on there, and you're putting it on another upper receiver or you're reusing it, you just squirt some oil on there, some ALG Go Juice or G96 CLP on your threads, and you put it on and away you go. All right. So with all the theoretical knowledge out there about galvanic corrosion, all right, you can apply the theory to this design issue, but exactly what happens in practice, okay? It's coated with a non-conductive material, that is the anodized, and you can take it from me that after 9 to 10 years of making rails, and I have two automatic lathes that make barrel nuts all day long, all right, aluminum barrel nuts, we've had one issue in those 9 years, and that certainly wasn't due to galvanic corrosion. Okay, so it's safe to use an aluminum barrel nut on your aluminum receiver. So thanks for listening today. And just remember, for all your gun needs, Brownells.com, everything you could want at Brownells, everything from cleaning supplies to ammunition, to all your reloading supplies, to all your tools that you work on guns, and of course, guns, they sell guns. Brownells.com, that is the ticket to the gun guy for everything he needs. Thanks for listening today, and take care. And stay safe here from North Wales, PA. Take care.